people will look at it and they're like quite shocked. And I feel like if it gets any bigger, even more people are going to notice it. It's restricting me every single day. Some days it feels bigger than others. I don't know when it's going to stop growing. I have a lipoma on my back and it is the size of a tennis ball. It looks very frumpy, like when an old person would have like a hunchback, and that's what it really actually makes me feel like.
Hi, Chels.
Yes, please.
When I see Chelsea upset and down about the lump, it does really worry me because it's not like Chelsea used to be before. I lie awake in bed thinking, well, how can her life improve if she doesn't get rid of this lump?
I don't want to end up being like a hermit sitting in my own flat on my own 24/7. Treatment would mean a massive thing to me. It'd be very life-changing. I'd be able to go out, start my life again, act like a 22-year-old instead of a 52-year-old. It's like literally my only hope to get removed by Dr. Emma that I've got left.
Hi, Chelsea.
Hi.
Hi, yes. I'm Dr. Emma. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Come with me. I like your yellow top.
Oh, thanks.
Come on in, Chelsea. Just have a seat up on the bed for me. What have you come along with?
Basically, I've got a lump on the top of the back of my neck.
OK.
And it has been growing about a year. And it just keeps getting bigger and bigger.
And did anything else happen within your life a year ago? So, were you unwell with anything?
I wasn't unwell. I just started to get a bit busier with work. Uh-huh. And then I did a lot less exercise than what I was actually used to.
And when you were doing less exercise at that time, did you put more weight on because of that?
Yeah, I think it was about a 7-pound weight gain.
And is there any pain associated with it?
The pain does start when I do squats with the weight bar. It actually does rest on the lump. For about 3 days afterwards, it restricts me from putting anything on my back or laying down, really. It's really painful.
OK, so what do you think this is?
I have been to my local GP. They have classed it as a lipoma.
So I want to have a look at this now. Is that
OK? Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Grant, Moddy, do you mind just to grab a rope? Is that OK? OK, so let's have a little look at this. Let's turn you round to here. So this is the lump, and it comes down from the very base of the neck. Is that painful at all if I press on it?
No, it's not, no.
No, good. With a lipoma, when you press on one side, it all tends to move together.
Right, OK.
Whereas this doesn't. When I'm pressing on one side, it doesn't feel like it's in any kind of a real capsule. The edges of this feel a little bit different because with a lipoma, you can almost feel that collection gathered together underneath the skin, whereas this is just almost a gentle slope without a very sharp difference. So I'm not convinced that this is a lipoma. Right, OK, that's fine. So do you want to have a seat up on the bed? So, Chelsea, this is something called a buffalo hump.
Right.
Now, I hate that term, a buffalo hump. It's really old-fashioned.
Yeah.
But do you know what it means? It means that there's an increase of fat in the dorso-cervical fat pad. So we all have these fat pads that sit across the top of our back. And in some people, extra fat can accumulate just there. And it got called a buffalo hump because buffaloes have quite a large dorso-cervical fat pad.
Yeah.
And that's why it got adapted to humans. So I will never use that term again because I hate it.
Yeah.
But just so you know what it is. The other thing that I suppose we've got to think about really is why was it not there and then within a year that it was? And I think it's probably been that bit of weight gain that you had has been enough to put the fat down in this area.
Yeah.
The difficult thing is losing weight doesn't tend to make the weight go from the fat pad in quite the same way. They can be removed by cutting them out. But actually, these fat pads do very well with removal with liposuction, which means that you can recover a bit more quickly and the scar is much smaller.
Yeah, that's brilliant.
What do you think about that? Because you thought this was a lipoma the whole time.
I'm quite shocked, but I'm excited to get it obviously finally removed. But it's even better now knowing that I'll have a smaller scar.
So liposuction gets rid of what's there, but it doesn't stop it coming back. And that really comes back down to your lifestyle, really, to try and ensure that there isn't that big spike in weight again, because I suspect it might just reform.
Yeah.
Now, I myself don't do liposuction, but my colleague, Mr. Richard Young, he does. He's a consultant plastic surgeon here, so we'll get you through to see Richard's secretary, I think, so that we can get everything all planned for you. Does that sound okay?
Yeah, that's brilliant. I'm excited now. I finally got some answers, which I'm glad about. And getting it liposuctioned is the best possible answer, really. It's put my mind at rest now, and there's no underlying health issues other than this fatty pad. Dr. Emma couldn't remove my lump, so she then referred me to Mr. Young, who's actually going to carry out my surgery today. There's a little bit of nerves, but I'm more excited than anything to get this lump removed after a whole year of getting bigger day by day, really.
Dr. Emma's referred Chelsea to me. She's developed a buffalo hump, which is a deposit of fat on the back of the neck, and that's visible through clothing. She's very conscious about it. Chelsea's going to have a general anaesthetic, so she's going to be asleep for the procedure, and we use liposuction with the aim of removing fat and contouring the back of the neck so it blends in with the surrounding skin. So we're going to have the table up, please. OK, thanks. That's fine.
Do you have any expected difficulties?
Hopefully not. We're very reliant on our anaesthetist today. He's going to have probably the hardest job because we have to place the patients face down in theatre, and that's always a little bit trickier than having them on their back in terms of maintaining their safety and looking after their airway. Rosetta, are you happy with everything?
Yeah.
Chelsea's on the table now, nicely anaesthetised, face down, so we're just going to make some little incisions to do the liposuction. And then the next thing we're going to do is start injecting some fluid and some local anaesthetic, so that helps preserve the blood vessels that are there, reduce the bruising, loosen the fat, and provide pain relief after the operation. So the buffalo hump at the moment measures about 6 centimetres when we do the pinch test, and the upper area of the neck measures about 2-2.5 centimetres. So we're ready to go with the liposuction. And suction on, lovely. Liposuction around the body has easier places and harder places, and the back of the neck can be a little harder than, say, the tummy. And the reason for that is that the tissues under the skin are very fibrous, so like scar tissue, quite hard tissue. And sometimes it's difficult to get through that scar tissue evenly and to get adequate amount of fat out to recontour it. To start with, we're just going backwards and forwards at the moment, just under the very central area to thin that out first. And we use a tube to do that, and that's called the cannula. And it has some blades at the end which help remove the fat. And you can see the fat from the buffalo hump coming down the suction tubing. The hardest bit with liposuction is ensuring that the skin's going to be even and you don't damage the skin on the undersurface of it, making sure that the fat under the skin matches in terms of thickness. So we're trying to avoid dips. Is there much fat coming?
No.
OK, we're probably done. Thank you very much. The pinch test looks pretty good and evenly matched to the surrounding tissues. Lovely, so we're finished, so thank you very much, everybody. Today went really well. We've had no problems with the operation or the liposuction. We got a lovely volume of fat out of the back of Chelsea's neck, and I think she's going to be very happy with the results.
Feeling a little bit tired, but I am actually feeling okay. I can feel where the lump used to be. It is actually now flat, no lump anymore. I just can't wait to get back home and fully recovered, but I'm really, really happy about it.
Now, my back is miles flatter than it was previously. The lump would really, really jut out to about there before I've had this done. So it's a very considerable change. I'm just so happy and so grateful, and I'm so pleased with the outcome.